as I'm in this spot here, and I have my opportunity to break, we have the opportunity for leg drags, and we also have the opportunity to cram this leg inside and start to work our head quarters position. So having this little deal is really nice. So again, I'm going to have him start out here and break grips. I'm going to step back and I'm going to stretch in here. For me to get in here really nicely is I want to step my foot deeper than his belt, but in the same direction that his knee is. For me, my favorite side smash pass to do is when they hold on to the foot here. So for me, I'm going to come into here and hipping in, and I'm in this zone here. What I'm looking for is if he keeps his hand on my leg, which is fine, I'm in here with two hands here, and I have the ability to drive my forehead to his chin, and as he starts to elevate with this butterfly hook, I'm going to allow my butt to come up, turn both of my feet through here, and I'm going to posture up as I shoot my knee through, and hook. For me, when I do this, I'm going to lift this up and make sure I swivel here. There's a battle of this knee, so I always want to hold my lower back here, and I want to win this inside position. From here, I can cross face and make it so uncomfortable that when he opens up this hip, he pulls me to full belt. So the way we're going to work on this, boom, I'm going to do a heave-a. I have an option for leg drag, I have my option for head quarters. For me, I come in, two on one, I allow my butt to elevate, but not my head, and come through. So, we always have that question, what happens if they don't let go of my ankle? Just going to smash a little bit. Okay, one more time. I'm in here at De La Hiva, it's got the grip. Boom. I put the leg between. I like to pass this over and get down and start smashing his hips. He's going to do something, so as he starts to elevate me up, turn my knees and cut over. Cross face and let him pull you into mount by him untangling his spine. Head course position at the side smash.
Thank you. Just smash your knee on your shirt.
I find like what being able to be the most acrobatic, dynamic way possible as I'm here. I'll ride all my weight on it. I use my hand. Wherever my hand is, I can project my body weight elsewhere. So I can pop in here. I want to be low and heavy, so the only option for me to try to do is the butterfly sweep. For me to get the sweep, I'm pinning his leg and I'm taking his head. Once I get that out, he'll open his head. But if I keep him, all I want to do is like, always find that you try to step over, you lose it. More than just keeping it relaxed and waiting for it. I
felt like I was just trying to get over his game. I was just dry humping his shin.
Post your hand below his waistline.
I wasn't complaining. Sit on you for so long, but I'll try to do it. Just smash my shit.
I know, but I'm not trying to be mean about it. I'm just trying to do it.
Stuck, but you can feel how your knees go that way, cross facing you that
way. Yeah, it's not a fun spot to be in.
It's not painful, but I'm like, oh, it gets a stretch. So
something
might pop, but I'm good.
It's uncomfortable. I wouldn't say it's pain.
Yeah, it's no like twister.
No.
Well, it's better than like doing it like up on the shoulder.
Michael gets all in that position this morning. who I talked this morning.
Morris?
Yep.
Yeah.
front on your shoulder, your torso. I was losing it. So there's a light down there. He's gonna break it, right? Break it out of order.
No, just using my shoulder to control your arm.
It's all good. Yeah. Okay, I don't want to step your man. I just didn't want to lose that position. I really left. Still tight, and I start going over, it's no good. If he can get this knee underneath of me, it's no good. If I can hip out, get his knee in front, it's no good. So for me, my battle that I really have is I can't get the hip out a little bit. Hips out a little bit, getting his knee inside. So that full first battle, now I start the elongation.
So your left knee goes in and then?
Yeah, so I'm here. I'm trying to open this up so I'll have it exhausted.
I'm always biting that cage for my crotch. I'm just pushing it down.
I wait for the wiper and then I roll the hip down to pin it. And I'm just trying to open his elbows up a little so I can extend like to get that open. Alright, so we're going to go look at option one. Really in my high quarter position, which is our inside cut pass. So the way I'm going to look at this is I'm going to walk into this open door and I'm going to step in, boom, as I'm right here. For me, I'm kind of just going to throw my body weight that way and roll into it. Okay? From here, everything's good. I'll come back to center and hold. The inside cut pass is always the strongest option. Boom, I'm in here. It's uncomfortable. He's trying to butterfly hook me. I switch his hips. For me, I'm trying to keep my head strong and split his jawbone. I work my way around. What we're going to look at after we do a couple reps of that is when he starts doing this battle, we'll walk him back to center and we do it again. So hit the inside cut pass. My
My knee is kind of over their crotch, not through it. If you saw that, I dodged him. Boom, I'm here. He starts to elevate. And then comes over. Two each, all three. One, two, three. Head close position.
You don't have to start from open guard or down.
Yeah, step into it offensively.
Split his jaw.
Thank you.
Your hips float over.
Yeah.
Because I'm driving you up and you're driving my knee that lateral. Mm-hmm. I'm driving up and you're driving me to my outside right.
So
the same way you want to be here, I think I was going too slow and I was thinking, overthinking it. Any less pressure on you with that one, or is it still felt like elevate? I wasn't sure because I heard you breathe. I didn't know if I was crushing your lung.
I was like trying not to crush. I'm just trying to be smooth.
I'm just fat in our shape.
No, you did.
I feel like I'm giving up my butt.
I missed the opportunity.
You can have a Jack on my thumb. I put my thumb on
his head
too. Make him wheeze.
Like I said, the only reason I went for the collar is not that
soft balance.
Trying to really close down on your knee and get that first step spot. How does it feel to you? I feel like I can get my head under your chin.
Yeah, you felt more centered, I guess.
Because he's right, I was out on my IT bend. Instead of feeling a knee on belly, it's not like it's getting worse, it's getting that better.
Starts to buck me around. I ride it. He's in a death grip with the quarter guard sitting here, or he's trying to frame up his own knee here to make it difficult. So what I'm going to do is put him back to center, which means I'm going to take my knee right to his solar plex and let his knee as far away as I can get. So when he poses a resistance to this, by either locking up the quarter guard or turning his own body, and he said, okay, I'm going to take you back to center. Hold me, thumb in. Again, I'm using my forearm. I'm not only trying to smash his face. I'm trying to move this way while holding him there, so I'm doing torsion on his neck. Boom. He starts to move. Boom. He adds some resistance. I pop up. I punch, grab. Again, if I have the ability to chase the back, I can do all of that without ever letting go of that swing of the grip. So the crossface, we were talking about that on Tuesday and Monday morning, is there's a lot of different ways to crossface somebody. The purpose for me to crossface, if he's flat on his back, is not for me to continue pushing him away. It's to stop him from turning into me. So I want you guys to be especially lower training and especially with training with our partners, during call, position, whatever. Again, I still gotta have a good technique. When I'm in this position here, I'm not trying to smash him further than he needs to go. I'm just trying to stop him from turning up. Okay? So I'm kind of monitoring. I'm not trying to smash him further than what is necessary. Okay? Turn into me, it's not going to be good for him, but I'm not putting enough pressure on him to smash him past his back. He's already on his back. I'm just preventing him from turning into me. Okay. You want to see it?
Yeah. You want to see it? Okay. He's rolling in. He's going to like it.
So again, I enter into this. Boom. I get my grip. He starts to move me. He gets a death grip. He frames it on me. So I'm going to push him back to center. Pull this up, punch the ground. Again, I'm not trying to smash him any further over. I'm just trying to stop him from turning up. I'll steer this over. I can chase it back with the grip. I'll switch to one side. So, for me, I just make that a heavy kind of rule of thumb that the purpose of a cross face is to stop them from turning on their side. They're already on the back, and I'm not going to be able to go anymore. I might as well be able to move you. Pull over! I can't pull over anymore! Alright, 1, 2, 3. Pull over! I can't pull over anymore!
I'm trying to go to this side of this.
You're over here, you're just putting driving the other solar flex. Now, pull up, thumb down, punch the back, flare the elbow up a little bit so you're not on a choke, but you're more on a drop. Now, grab the sleeve grip, and you're going to cut over.
Sorry, you did it. I know.
as soon as she throws some resistance in, so her resistance is going to be, she locks up a core card, and or she starts bringing her knee to her chest. So you want to press her shoulders and belly button.
It looks fine. The movements look good.
I'm just going to scream from work from whatever this is not here. Only from Merlin.
So flexed.
But it's not the knee, it's the
pulling of it.
The
yeah.
Bicep.
Yeah.
It's making you strongest.
There you go. Yeah, that's how you should think of it. I'm just making you strong.
You're making you strong yeah. By picking me up. Yeah, I still feel like I'm getting my back. No, I know I'm not.
Oh, yeah.
I know I'm not.
It's dead. It's dead.
That's true. Instead of holding the throat, holding like the man holding like right on the
head.
So, the best way to do it is like that.
Maybe. Not with my arm trap like that. So.
You let go of the arm, maybe.
I know.
Series is a Lovato Junior pressure passing series. Headquarters to the pass. pulls resistance, take him back to center, crawl space, come through there. And he's got a secret choke off for this series.
The best way to get to headquarters from the open guard is starting breaking the day to do the grip.
From open, so if I'm down here, same way I would go in, same the way I like to do the toy on there.
Yeah.
Bump guys into it.
Yeah.
My stuff in. Okay. Rather than going to fall.
Yeah. Okay.
Resistance. So it's the same body position I like for Toriando. Crook of the knee, start this way. So follow me to crook of the knee. Start to step to your left. And then step your right knee and move into it. Positional sparring. One person is going to be in for hold whatever 2 minutes. If he wins the battle, he gets a fresh person bouncing back and forth, but he'll stay in the same position. So we're going to positional spar from the back. So Mike's got tags back, tag escapes where Mike submits him, tags out, Mike's got moons back and forth, back and forth. So whoever starts and has the back stays in it for the full 2 minutes and gets to switch with his partner. You guys have already people, or you still want to show the same thing to you guys?
Take a stutter step, penetrate into the.
My first thought is you're baiting that. You're baiting that half guard.
Oh, I like it though. It's like still on the spin, like with angers and stacking about 2 to 4 yonder, which I like to do. It's like instead of 4 yonder,
right here.
I'm just waiting to see if I can get headquartered.
I'm sorry, I can't hear
you. What's the clatter?
So I don't know who he was talking to.
Yeah, that's true.
got the back.
You know, man.
You want it?
I starts. Win. Yeah.
Okay.
Three. Minutes, person gets it all the time, and then switch who's on top the second round, and then a new partner. Okay.
Yeah.
I try to.
Thank you.
resetting once they escape.
Yeah.
Or just run. We get it. I feel like the half guard is really
Ruby.
Any questions?
When we were doing the headquarter position earlier,
yeah.
You get that call where you say stay inside caller. Yeah. The purpose of that is like when you come up, you become pinned or what's that?
Anytime that I'm in a top position as a cross caller, I can get judged by. So. If I'm like so and I have this,
yeah.
There's kind of slippage here. So one, I'm using this to try to keep his shoulders as close to his knee. So here. His escape or his relief on this is a back extension. So I'm trying to stop the back extension. If I'm here, he can go face down, do a back extension. There's stupid stuff called donkey guard where he can roll completely over and do some arms and stuff like that. So when I have the grips here, it's me controlling his posture when he's on the ground. It's to stop him from getting to a position where he makes sense. In here, then to stop the back extension. Down, and I have a solid object here. If I step on this, I'm putting pressure through his lungs here. Okay, so I always like use the analogy, if I have a 2x4 here, and I step on the 2x4, it's going to create more pressure into him than if I just whip him.
smashing his lung here, and I'm tight. So this gives me the most ability to kind of be dynamic to get into my spot. So again, I don't like heavy cross facing. So the way I go to this is I come down the collar, I go to right where the shoulder is, I go right to his hip, and I essentially pop up for my surfing position. Knee cross belly, it's basically knee cross the flanks of his hips, and I'm surfing him over. That's ultimately what I'm trying to do, is again stop him from turning up. So I'm going to pass his guard, boom, get to my wrestling side now. I'm going to lift my hip a little bit, drop my pressure, hand to shoulder, hand to opposite hip, pop up. Where my opposite hip is, I'm going to cover that with my knee, and I come over and hold. For the most traditional knee on belly, my foot has to be on the ground, my knee can't be touching, and I'm going to pick him up. So, uncomfortable, but it's across his bones of his hip, not across the soft tissue of his belly. So, each to do this. So again, pop in, wrestling side control, I got my 2 points, I'm going to lift my hip up, drop. Hand's going to come down the knee, right to his shoulder, hand's going to come to his pants, right on his hip, I'm going to go surfing, pop up, and knees across the body, grab the pant. Very, very dominant position, you know, belly, it's worth 2 points. It's a good thing to be able to do, I know. And again, we're setting up the dynamic to give him a singular place to go. So let's go ahead and pull through that. One on each side, switch, 2 sets. 1, 3. 1, 2, 3.
That's my wife, I'll be on every time.
I'm sure you'll be affected with your nails on your chair.
We all
right hands are
nice, or is it just not doing it?
Alright. One last little drill will work, which is going to be a deep takedown. It's by far probably my favorite to do. So it's kind of like a single leg trip today, but I usually do. So for me, when I'm in here and I'm working, I'm going to work on pulling so he's weighted, and then I'm going to kind of shoot like the front side of the single. So this knee and up here, but I'm dragging this down. So I have to use this, let's say, if I allow him to be upright or postured, grabbing anything, he's got really good base balance. So as soon as I get it, it's going to be a combination of pushing, pulling, snapping it down. The thing I'm going to do on this is I'm heavy here, and I'm going to engage my arm into a grip, and I'm just going to drop my weight. And hold it. So same side, change my elevation and use all my weight to do it, and then shoot in to the opposite knee. Essentially, I'm going to drag that big string pump in,
Doesn't have to. So this single has like two variations where it's like one is the single and one is like the cross pick type of movement where it's like a it's like a snatch single almost with a collar.
So it's like because this is like a sweep single. Wait, this you just hear. And you're like, so it's like you're pushing, if they don't get it,
then you're pulling. The sweep, you just circling the whole time.
Oh. But same,
I've actually only done this a couple of times.
I'm sure.
Well, because it's my fire.
Yeah, it's all the time. Like this, like,
if this, like, you can push, you can gather, and then you just have to wait.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you just start pushing this down, bang, bang, bang. Like that. You know,
but yeah, that, the more you just take, like, you just go
hit,
and just, yeah, exactly.
Same foot,
like footwork, similar.
The same footwork, and
you just go to the outside foot instead of inside.
And it all depends on where your feet are. If you leap foot forward,
yeah, no, exactly. Well, like an Ireland, you're just here,
and you go there.
With a single, you're here.
This one, the single, and you go there.
the weak foot forward, the single. If the weak foot's back,
it's all very similar. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. I don't hear very often when I hear the pretty seat.
It works pretty well. Back exposure. I don't like on it.
Well, that's why they used to call
it. I know, you have to, but
that's why I can hit it.
Go ahead and line up.